In this video series, we are going to explore Canadian provinces and territories. We will look at some basic information such as size, population, capital cities, economy and so on. I will try my best to include some unique, fun and interesting bit about each province and territory. I will also compare and rank the provinces and territories to see the relationship between them. We are not competing. Each and every province is unique and very important to Canada. I am going to make this a series of 3 videos. Part 1, this video will cover British Columbia, Alberta, Saskatchewan and Manitoba. Part 2 will have Ontario, Quebec, Newfoundland and Labrador, New Brunswick, Nova Scotia and Prince Edward Island. Part 3 will have 3 territories, Yukon, Northwest Territories and Nunavut. Please consider subscribing to our channel and turn on the notification so you'll be notified by YouTube when I upload the next video. Thank you for joining and welcome to our channel. Are you ready to explore Canadian provinces and territories? I am. Canada is the second largest country in the world with a total area almost 10 million square kilometers. It is divided into 10 provinces and 3 territories. You may be asking, what is the difference between provinces and territories? Great question. The major difference is that provinces get their power and authority from constitution. If there is any change in responsibility between federal government and the provincial government, the constitution has to be amended or changed. Whereas territorial government get the power directly from the Parliament of Canada, and any changes in responsibility is the discretion of the Parliament. Basically, provincial governments and the Government of Canada has a formal division of powers and responsibilities. Government of Canada gives certain powers to territorial government. First, let me list all the provinces from west to east. At the west coast, we have British Columbia, then Alberta, Saskatchewan, Manitoba, Ontario, Quebec. Then we have Newfoundland and Labrador in blue. Then you can see a tiny small green island. That's Prince Edward Island. When you come down, you can see Nova Scotia in red and New Brunswick in orange. Can you remember them? If not, let me tell you a trick. Can you remember the word Basmoquet? Yeah, Basmoquet. B for British Columbia, A for Alberta and S for Saskatchewan and so on. Then look at the 3 provinces in the southeast corner of the map. The smallest island is Prince Edward Island. Other 2 are New Brunswick and Nova Scotia. They both start with N, so PNN. Then the 3 territories. The western one is Yukon, then Northwest Territories and Nunavut. So YNN. So now you have 10 provinces and 3 territories. You can remember them, right? Now let's jump into the provinces and start with British Columbia. British Columbia's landscape is impressive. It has massive mountain ranges, beautiful beaches that could rival any beach in the world, and a luscious green forest with lots of wildlife, including some rainforest. Yes, you heard me right, rainforest in Canada. Out of all the provinces and territories, British Columbia has the mildest climate. On the west coast, temperatures really drop below freezing. Flowers often bloom as early as February. Henderson Lake in Victoria Island receives more rainfall throughout the year than any other place in North America. You get my point. Not all of Canada is frozen tundra. BC's capital is Victoria on the Vancouver Island. Yes, it is named after Queen Victoria. Population is about 5 million. It is the 3rd most populous province. Half of the people live in Metro Vancouver area, making Vancouver the largest city. BC take up about 944,000 square kilometers. It is the 5th largest of all provinces and territories. British Columbia's GDP is about $250 billion. It is the fourth largest in Canada. Service and agriculture are the main pillars of its economy. You'll be surprised to know, BC is the third largest producer of cranberries and blueberries in the world, as well as home to many vineyards and wineries. BC's ice wine are really, really good. Pair them with fruity desserts, cheesecake, ice cream, and soft cheese. Try it. You won't be disappointed. Next province is Alberta. Alberta has endless array of beautiful landscape, including fertile prairies, stunning foothills, mountains, endless amount of thick forest, badlands, tons of dinosaur fossil, and many breathtakingly beautiful lakes. Lake Louise is one of the most visited and photographed lake in the entire world. It is popular because its beautiful turquoise water that reflect the surrounding mountains and Victoria Glacier. Do you hate rats? Alberta is the only rat-free zone in North America. They spend millions of dollars keeping these rats away. Alberta has some interesting structures and statues. A small town named Vulcan is famous with Star Trek fans. They took their name to heart and built a 31-foot Starship Enterprise replica next to the Starship-shaped visitor center. A small town called St. Paul has a UFO landing pad. You know, just in case alien want to visit. Another small town called Mandaire has a 42-foot sausage statue. Trust me, it's true. A small lakeside community by Sylvan Lake has an inland lighthouse. Yep, no ships, no boats, but lighthouse. The weird structures. I'm not sure what's with Alberta. West Edmonton Mall is the largest mall in North America. It offers much more than shopping. There's a roller coaster, water park, skating rink, and much, much more. Alberta's capital is Edmonton, but the largest city is Calgary. Alberta's population is about 4.4 million. It is the fourth most populous province and territory. Alberta is the sixth largest of all provinces and territories in terms of total area, with the area of about 662,000 square kilometers. Alberta has the third largest GDP in Canada, with a GDP of about 338 billion. Petroleum, agriculture, and technologies are main pillars of its economy. The next province is Saskatchewan. Its landscape is comprised of grassland, aspen parkland, and boreal forest. It is pretty much a flatland, but it has over 100,000 lakes and many, many sand dunes. Athabasca sand dunes are one of the most northerly active sand dunes on the planet. It is massive, span over 100 kilometers. If you want to know more about them, I did a video a while ago as part of the Canadian Landscape series. I'll put that in the description. Little Manitou Lake is a lighter version of Dead Sea. It is three times saltier than the ocean. You can actually float in it. Regina is the provincial capital. The largest city is Saskatoon. About half the population of the province live here. It is the seventh largest of all provinces and territories, with a total area of little less than 652,000 square kilometers. Population is about 1.1 million. It's the sixth populous place in Canada. It is the fifth largest economy, with about $82 billion. Traditionally an agro-based economy, now highly diverse. Saskatchewan still grows a large portion of Canada's grain, pulse crop, canola, and mustard. Saskatchewan exports almost one-third of world's lentils, beans, peas, and chickpeas. Saskatchewan also grows one-third of global supply of mustard. These crops do well thanks to longer summer days. Sun can shine up to 17 hours a day. Saskatchewan is the world's largest producer of potash. Over 95% of the potash is used in fertilizer. The next province is Manitoba. Manitoba is mostly flat like Saskatchewan, with few hills, small mountains, and numerous rivers and many large lakes. Most of the province is covered in coniferous forest and home to epic wildlife. Do you want to watch a Northern Light or Aurora Borealis put on a light show? Churchill, Manitoba is the best place in the world to see Aurora Borealis or Northern Light. The whole world. It is also a polar bear capital of the world and the best place to watch beluga whales. Winnipeg is Manitoba's capital and the largest city. It is also the geographical center of Canada. Everyone's favorite Winnie the Pooh's full name is Winnipeg. A soldier adapted the bear and named it Winnipeg after his hometown. Winnie was later donated to London Zoo and she was a hit with the visitors. Emergency. Call 911. Did you know Winnipeg was the first in the world to implement the 911 emergency phone number? It is the 8th largest of all province and territory with an area of about 647,000 square kilometers. It is Canada's 5th most populous province and territories with a population about 1.3 million people. Manitoba's economy is 6th largest in Canada with about $73 billion. It is based largely on natural resources. Agriculture is vital to the province economy. Other major industries are transportation, manufacturing, mining, forest, energy and tourism. Most common agricultural activity is cattle farming, growing grains and oil seeds. Manitoba is one of the leading producers of potatoes and supply potatoes to McCain Foods and French fries to McDonald's and Wendy's. This is the wrap for the first part of this video series. The next one we will focus on Ontario, Quebec and the Atlantic provinces. So thank you for watching and hope you learned something new and had some fun watching it. Please don't forget to subscribe and smash the like button. Talk to you all in the next video.